everyone, welcome back to my YouTube channel. Today I have a brand new video for you guys. It is not like the other ones that I've done, not any Harry Potter related or unboxing related videos. It's just gonna be me talking today. Yeah, so I've been just meaning to talk about this for a while. I said it before that I go to University of Minnesota Morris, and I've been just having a lot of problems in my campus, and I see not a lot of people do videos for Morris specifically talking about like issues and things that you have to face as a freshman when you come in. So I was like, you know, let's make a video for all those freshmen that are coming into college not knowing what the heck is going on in college. First of all, this video is all my opinion. Not everybody had to go through the same stuff at all, but this is just my opinion, so yeah, you don't have to get all worried because something happened to me. That doesn't mean that has to happen to you, which in most cases it will. But okay, let's just get into the video. It's not like me just rambling in here. So the first thing I wanted to talk about is that just pisses me off a lot is that you have to do parking tickets for your car, and it is just a lot of schools do that. It's not just Morris that does that, but like it is very idiotic that a student has to pay a parking ticket to park in their own campus. Like, we already pay however much $1,000 that we pay for the school, and they already get that much money from us, but then we have to pay $130 for a year-long parking pass. And thank God they just changed that this year. In the previous years, it would have been just like you pay for like certain parking lot and you have to stay there. You cannot park anywhere else on campus. And it is just so idiotic. Like, we already pay too much money to school, and then they go ahead and take $130 from us, even more, which is like very unneeded and unnecessary. They could have literally taken that us from what we pay already with the tuition and all that crap. So yeah, that's just one thing that I found it very stupid, in my opinion. And I know a lot of other schools do that too, and many students complain about it. Honestly, we should complain about it. We're college students, we're already in debt, and now we have to pay this much extra to park on campus. It's like, that's very dumb. But yeah, that was one thing that I wanted to bring up. So the next one I'm going to talk about is specifically for Morris. As many of you may know, University of Minnesota's first campus was in the Twin Cities area, where like Minneapolis is, but the Morris is just, you know, like extension, another campus. The one thing that I hate about Morris is not the faculty, not the school, it's just where its location is. Not many students know that when they come in as a freshman. I am an orientational group leader, which I go to school a week earlier than everybody else, and I welcome all the freshmen and I try to get them to, like, you know, adjust to this new change. Morris is a tiny town. It is like 5,000 to 6,000 people live in, I believe, and mainly because most people come there because of the university. And we do not have any stores, any malls, anything nearby, nothing. The only two stores that we have are Shopko and Willy's, which are definitely way overpriced for a student, for a college student especially. And you know, it's just like I cannot even talk right now, like my words are not even coming. Like, I'm just so curious why they picked Morris, like not nearby. For example, there's Alexandria. They could have picked Alexandria. At least there's Walmart, Target, like stuff like that. Walmart from Morris is almost 45 to an hour, like 45 to 60 minutes away. That's a lot of driving. Like, nobody would want to do that. And I believe that is one of the main reasons why we don't get a lot of like freshmen coming in, because, you know, it's just so, it's middle of, in the middle of nowhere, literally, like middle of nowhere. And don't get me wrong, like there is always stuff to do in Morris, but like if you just want to be around, if you grew up in a big city, if you're from a big city, when you get there, it's just gonna be very overwhelming. I have friends that are even coming even smaller towns, which they're overwhelmed by Morris, but like I grew up in the capital of Turkey and I'm in Minneapolis. Like literally, it's just like I grew up in a big city. When I go there, there's nothing to do for me. Like I want to go out, I want to walk around, I want to see it, like at least even a freaking Walmart. Like I want to see Walmart. I want to walk in there. Like it's just very upsetting. I don't know. I don't very much like it, and because of its small location, lately, I've been getting a lot of anxiety and depression because of it, because like I don't want to stay on campus. It gets really, really freaking, it just gets very unbearable after a while if you see the same people all the freaking time and you want to just get out, see other people, and just like move away from the campus. But there is no way you can do that. You just have to walk around and go to Willy's or Shopko, which is very small and very pricey, so it's like kind of upsetting. So that's another thing that I found it very, very upsetting, that I thought y'all should know, whoever's watching. Maybe you're a freshman that is going to Morris. You should know these things, because like when any school advertise their own college, obviously they're not gonna put all the bad stuff out. These are not like horrible things. You might not mind it. Like I said, I have a lot of friends that just come to Morris and love it because they like small towns. They grew up in a smaller town. They like it. But I'm just saying, putting these out there is for everyone to know it, not just like, you know, I want to advertise this. I'm not saying Morris is a terrible school because our faculty is awesome, and that's one of the reasons why I'm still in Morris instead of like transferring to Twin Cities or any other campuses of University of Minnesota. So that's one of the reasons, but like there are these small nasty details that you need to pay attention. And for example, another one is if you're a freshman, you have to live in a dorm, which is like highly recommended. I don't know if it's required. I believe it's required, but like it's very highly recommended. I mean, yes, but living in dorms just sucks. If you are a female and live in a dorm, it's not good. It's not good. There's a lot of disgusting girls, and I don't like the way they arrange your roommate with you. They say we're gonna put certain people like they give you this like test, online test, you have to fill it out to see like your personality, and they try to match another person's personality with yours, but that never goes well. I know a lot of friends that had problem with their roommates, and it's just very idiotic how they do that system. It's just, I don't like the dorms. I am living in one right now, and I will be living in one next year because, you know, I cannot afford to go off campus. But, you know, there are things that are just very done poorly and that could get better, but for some reason, no one is like giving any shit to it, like not get putting any time or anything, which is kind of upsetting. If like, yeah, for freshmen and sophomores, if you live on campus on a dorm, you have to have cafeteria's meal plan, which is like 2,000 freaking something dollars per semester. And wow, like that's just wow. Oh my God. I'm a vegetarian. I was a vegetarian when I started college, and my cafeteria does not have any decent vegetarian food whatsoever. And almost all my friends that are vegetarian moved off campus just because of that problem, because they cannot make enough food in the cafeteria for vegetarians. And it's not like, don't get me saying like, oh, there's like 10,000 students that are eating meat and just like this 10 kids. It's not like that. The proportion of like vegetarians in my school is actually very much because I talk to most of them. There are a lot of vegans, vegetarians, and we don't just get a lot of food done. They usually have two, three kinds of meat, but they only have steamed vegetables or like very crappy, poorly done tofu for vegetarian students. That is so bad. Like, literally, I hate that. That's one, I think that's my number one dislike about my school, that their cafeteria sucks so hard and they can get better. We don't need three kinds of different meat. We don't need turkey, pork, and chicken. We can just have, you know, like a little bit of veggie burgers. They do it once in a while, but then non-vegetarian students eat that too. So when it comes to us, there is none left because everybody just took it. So I feel like everybody should have their own meal choices by like whether they eat meat or not. And that's how people should get served based on their diet plan. But they're not doing that, which is very poorly done. And I am very unhappy about it. So if you are a freshman coming into University of Minnesota Morris, think about that, because you're not gonna get a lot of food. There's salad bars, there's always like sandwich spot and all that crap, but like I don't get a lot of vegetarian food, and which is causing me to cook my own food in the dorms. But then I was a sophomore, so I had to pay the meal plan, like almost 4,000 something a year, and extra buy another like grocery full of stuff to cook my own meal. It's just very, very pricey and expensive. And yeah, I just cannot believe my school is making us go through something like this. But people like me and other couple of vegetarian friends went up to the dean. Hopefully they got our message, they'll change it. Hopefully, I'm very much hoping this, because I have to live in the dorms next year. Even though I'm not gonna have the full meal plan, I will still eat there because I have to have it, unfortunately, because you have to have something. So hopefully they change that, hopefully. But yeah, that's kind of what I wanted to talk about in my video, because I see on YouTube a lot of places do, like a lot of YouTubers that like put videos about their school, but I didn't really see a lot of Morris videos. So, you know, make sure you know these things before coming to the school, because I don't want anyone to get like discouraged. I don't want anyone to just like walk in there without knowing nothing and just, wow, it's a big shock in your face, basically. I, for example, did not know where Morris even was. My main goal of from university was to actually get away from my parents, because I wanted to separate and I wanted to get my own. I like literally did not even finish that sentence. I wanted to separate from them. I wanted to separate myself from them and get my own freedom. That's what I cared most about. Well, obviously school too, but like that's why I picked Morris. If I knew there were these problems, I would have picked another campus like Duluth or Rochester or Crookston. Like, I would have done something, but I picked Morris and I didn't do all these research. So when I went there, I was like, oh my God, this town is so freaking small. What the heck am I gonna do in here? So, you know, I don't want anyone to go through this stress as I did. So, you know, make sure to do all your research before getting into your college, because then you're gonna get a bigger disappointment. It's better to watch these things and prepare yourself than just walk into the freaking place and be like, whoa, where am I? I didn't apply for this place. Well, I hope you guys like this video. I did like this video myself. I wanted to make this video for so long because I was just like, you know, I talked to my friends and I was keeping this in me, and I'm like, you know, I should just make a video so everybody knows. Like I said, I'm an orientational group leader. I go to college a week before all the students start. And when I see freshmen coming in, like some of them are disappointed by what they see, and I'm just like, you know, have you not done your research? Have you not like learn what kind of school this is? Have you not like looked at its location? And they're like, no, I taught, you know, like whatever, I just picked the school. You know, like people do that just like I did. So I hope you guys find this video helpful. I wasn't trying to discourage any all y'all, whatever that even means. I'm just trying to be helpful for you guys to make a better and safe choice. And if you have any questions about Morris, especially University of Minnesota Morris campus, not just Twin Cities or like any random campus, because I get asked that a lot too. I'm like, why, what? But yeah, if you have any questions, comment them down below. I would be honest as I can answering your questions, because we need these kind of videos. Even though Morris can be a small campus, we need these videos for incoming freshmen to see and ask their questions. Okay, this is the end of the video. I hope you like this. If you like this, give it a big thumbs up. Subscribe to my channel. I don't know what I'm doing with my hands. Just ignore my hands. And comment down below if you have any questions. And I will hopefully see you on my next video. Bye.